Today we're going to upgrade the QNAP TS-451 NAS device to 16 gigabytes of memory. Officially, QNAP supports a maximum of 8 gigs, but if you do some research on the internet, you'll find out that the TS-451 does indeed accept up to 16 gigabytes. However, because QNAP doesn't have that official support, you should keep in mind that you're at risk of things not working if QNAP ever decides to enforce that memory requirement. We'll be using the Crucial 16GB DDR3L SO-DIMM kit of two sticks of 8GB each. The only tool we'll need is a Phillips head screwdriver. Before we start this project, I'll log into the QTS operating system and verify how much memory I currently have. Open up the control panel and go to General Settings and navigate to System Status. The TS-451 comes with 1 GB of memory out of the box. Tabbing to Hardware Information, you'll see that there are two memory slots, but only one is populated with a 1 GB stick. If you go to Resource Monitor, you can find out in the System Resource section just how much of the 1 GB is being used and how much memory has to be swapped out to disk. Finally, you can pop open the dashboard to check the amount of memory used. So, to prepare for surgery on the hardware, I'll go ahead and shut down the system, confirm, and then we'll start the disassembly. After you power down, the first step is to take out the hard drives if you have them in your unit. To remove a drive, just lift the latch and pull it out. Now, I have all four slots filled with hard drives, but even if you have less than four, you'll want to remove the plastic caddies anyways. You'll see the chassis is empty, and you can see the faint trace of a motherboard as you peer down the hole. Flip the case around. These are the four screws that you'll need to remove. As I'm taking out the screws, you'll notice I'm wearing an anti-static wrist strap, which I highly recommend when opening up any type of computer so that you're grounded before touching any electronics. The case itself is made of two plastic pieces. There's a seam on the right side that marks the place where the two pieces come together. From the viewpoint of the rear, as we see here, you'll want to push in the right side or pull out the left side, as the case may be, and the two pieces slide along a groove. After you place the case on its side, the left piece pops right off. At this point, there are six smaller screws that we'll need to remove. Let's start with the two screws on this side. These screws secure the hard drive cage onto the chassis. On the other side, we'll do the same thing and remove the two screws there. And finally, let's remove the two screws on the top. Keep in mind that the case itself is on its side, so when I say top, I mean it from the viewpoint that I'm showing here. The cage is now ready to be separated. Pull up on the cage. Notice that it was held in place not only by the screws, but by a small connector to the motherboard. I'll need to grab the new Crucial memory sticks. To remove the old one, use your thumbs to push outward on the two silver clips, as you see here. The memory stick will pop up, allowing you to hold it between your fingers and pull it out. We'll set that aside into the packaging of the Crucial memory, and then we'll install the new memory. There's a small notch on the memory stick which you'll want to line up with the notch on the motherboard. Gently push the memory into the slot and then press down so that the clips engage the stick. The second memory slot is a bit harder to get to, so I'm going to rotate the case to access it. The installation is a little tricky. There's not a lot of space to maneuver. This time, the label is facing away from you. Grip the memory stick from its sides and finesse it into place. Push on the memory through this hole in the metal piece to secure it into the slot, and then press on it to engage the clips, just like you did with the first stick. As far as the memory goes, that's it. What you want to do is reverse the steps to put all the parts back together again. Let's place the cage back onto the motherboard, making sure the connector aligns with the slot on the motherboard. Then, as I rotate the case around again, I'll secure the two screws on the side of the cage to the chassis. Then I'll flip it around and take care of the two screws on this side of the cage. Finally, on the top, we'll finish it off with the remaining two screws. From this view, where we're looking at the bottom of the case, all you have to do is place the plastic shell onto the bottom piece. But as you do so, make sure that the small triangles on each piece line up. Then you just slide the two parts together until you hear a click. After you insert your hard drive caddies into place, let's start up the server and go back into the QTS operating system and confirm that our memory upgrade took. Let's start the control panel again. We'll go to General Settings, and then System Status. And you can see that we now have 16 gigabytes of memory in our unit. Under Hardware Information, it reports that the two memory slots are filled with the Crucial Technology brand memory with 8 gigabytes each. The Resource Monitor shows the correct amount of memory, as does the dashboard. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.